Good morning, fellow YouTubers. Scott Watts here with Watts Way Farms, and welcome to another beautiful day here on the farm. Getting started a little later today than I normally do. I'm actually on vacation this week from my daytime job. Not really doing anything, so I guess we'll call it a staycation. But, you know, it gives me the ability not to have to get up as, you know, be outside by sunlight to get the morning chores done so that I can be back at my home office in time to start the day job. So, in today's video, I'm going to show y'all how to make a pig water, the pig water that I use. And I think I have stumbled across what is probably the easiest and, you know, probably cheapest leak-proof pig water you can have. It doesn't require any silicone to seal it up. It doesn't require drilling big holes in the top of your barrel so that you can, you know, acrobatically dive into the barrel to try to attach bulkhead or other adapters. And, you know, it's designed so that the pigs, it has a little play so that it's not breaking the pig nipples off, so you don't need a big inventory of spares to keep on hand for when that happens. So that's what we're gonna do in today's video. But first, I'm gonna check on the pigs. As you can see, as soon as I walked out here, they came up to investigate. They're still a bit skittish. Whenever you get close to them, they'll run, but they sure are curious to want to see what's going on. So let's get started. Since I'm out here, I always start the morning by checking on the pigs. And again, it kind of starts my day, puts me in my happy place. And I also take the opportunity to test my fence. You can see I've got 7.8 or 7,800, 7,900 volts. I did yesterday, I had a little, Energizer battery operated down there that I'd purchased from Tractor Supply. It was kind of a impromptu purchase because, as I mentioned, I think in a previous video, I've had these pigs 17 days now, but actually the farmer I bought them from called me and said they were ready for pickup on December 28th, which was probably a 3 or 4 days earlier than I was anticipating. So the Speedrite 3000 Energizer that I had ordered had not arrived yet. So I ran to Tractor Supply, bought the $100 DC Energizer that they had, and it worked pretty good. I mean, it was 0.7 joules, which doesn't sound like a whole lot, but I was still getting around 6,000 volts on this little pin. But what I did was temporarily, I did this yesterday, so I ran the spool of poly braid from here all the way over to just at that tree line, which is where my main fence is. And if you don't know if you can see in the distance, but see if I can zoom in. So right there is my solar charger that you saw from my other day's video. And so this is that's my semi-permanent high tensile fence there. So I just ran a piece of poly and from that fence down to here, and then just connected it with the alligator clips. Now, one thing that's interesting to note, if I come over here and I take a test, you know, just like over there, I've got 7,700 volts. But if I take this feed off, right, and connect it directly to it, you see it kicks all the way up to 9,600 volts. So I'm losing a lot here. And I'm pretty sure I know why that is. It's this bottom line is 6 inches from the ground. And in the 17 days since I've gotten these pigs, they've done a lot of rooting. They know where that line is, but they push right up next to it. So there's a lot of, especially you get around the back where the undergrowth of the straw and grass and dirt mixed all together, they've pushed it right up to the fence, and I think it's grounding it out. But that's part of the reason I want such a hot fence, because even with it grounded out, and I'm still pushing this 78 right now, 100 volts, and that's still a pretty hot fence. I think that's plenty hot for any pig to, if they touch it, they're gonna know it. So I might probably go in and maybe this weekend
and with just like a little hoe or rake, and maybe push that back, or maybe even raise that bottom line up now that I've had the pigs for a couple weeks and they know, obviously I can trust that they know this fence and respect it. I don't need to be quite as worried with it, so I might be able to raise it up. So here's the water that I'm going to build today. It's, you know, my own, I guess, pseudo creation, but like everything else, because I'm new to this, I've got a farming degree from YouTube, I believe. Everything I've done is either an idea I saw on YouTube or a amalgamation of ideas that I saw on YouTube, or, you know, or YouTube and then blog posts and other websites, and talked to a few people, but, you know, candidly, I'm still meeting the neighbors and other farmers in my area, so I just don't know a whole lot to talk to. So you'll notice in this finished product here, and I'll show y'all, I didn't have to cut a hole in the top, and this thing doesn't leak. I mean, the water on the ground here, which is very little, is from the pigs drink on this. They come up and drink on it, and, you know, but some of it spills on the ground. So this is what we're building today. So let's get started. So the bulk of the videos I see on YouTube with regards to how to make a pig water all really center around buying this little bulkhead adapter and then cutting a hole or something in the top of your barrel so that you can get access to it. And you see, I've seen the videos where the guys try to cut the hole small and then they're struggling to get their hand in, and then they're cutting the hole big to try to, you know, ease get down into it to attach that bulkhead. And when I bought this barrel, I just don't know, I mean, it has two screw on lids already, and so I thought there ought to be a way to make this so that I don't have to cut it open. I mean, it's got holes in it already. It's going to hold water, so I mean, I really don't need to get in it except maybe to drain it down the road. But again, I got two holes on the top that I can do that with. So I spent quite a few hours researching and, you know, scouring the internet trying to find a better solution, and I think I got one. So let's go through the parts and let me show you how easy this is to build. Okay, so here are the parts you're going to need for this super simple DIY pig waterer. So the first thing you're gonna have to get is one of these 55 gallon plastic barrels. Make sure you get food grade. This one contained soy sauce or some sort of fish sauce, and I noticed because it really smelled when I got it. The lady I bought it from said she rinsed it out, but that was all, so it still had a pretty good smell. Now, I found these on Facebook Marketplace. I mean, literally when I searched, a bunch of them came up, so I just picked the one closest to me. Those cost $15. I think it was a good deal for it. I did. When I got home, I rinsed it some more. I soaked it in a bleach solution for a few days to get that smell out, and then even rinsed it some more. So I'm sure it is good and safe now for my pigs. You're also going to need some pig nipples. Now, I bought a 5-pack of the heavy duty stainless ones. And what I like about these is there were some cheaper ones on there, but, you know, these appear to be pretty heavy duty. They've got this little screen in the back, and they also have adjustable flow rates. Now, I didn't adjust the flow rates on the first one I built. I tested it, and it's putting out just over two and a half cups of water per minute. And what I read online was that for growing pigs, they need a flow rate of about 2 to 3 cups per minute. Now, my pigs get, you know, all the water they want, but they've also got, you know, the standing water from that little spring kind of mini pond that I've got in there. So they're getting all the water they need. You're also going to need some 3/4-inch PVC pipe. I bought one 10-foot stick at Lowe's. It was less than $3 and had enough to make all of this one and the one previous. Now, I cut these to about 8 inches, 8 to
10, 12. I don't think that size is as important, but you are going to need a little bit of length on this in order for it to work. Obviously, you're going to need, these are 3/4 inch smooth to threaded to connect the pig nipples to the PVC, some Teflon tape to go around the threads to get a good connection here, and then just some PVC primer and glue. Also, you're going to need a 1.5 inch drill bit. I think this probably could have worked with the, you know, a cheaper spade bit, but I wanted to make sure I had a good clean hole, so I went with the keyhole. And then this is the kind of the magic ingredient, if you will. This is called a Uniseal. This is the label, if that will read or not. These are 3/4 inch Uniseal flexible tank adapter bulkhead. And the thing to note on this is, even though you're drilling a 1.5 inch hole, you want to make sure you buy the 3/4 inch Uniseal. It's the size, it based off the size of the pipe that goes in it, not the size of the hole you're going to drill. Trust me on this, because if you buy the 1.5 inch Uniseal thinking that that's the size, because that's the size hole you drill, then you're going to be having to deal with a returns on Amazon. So I'm going to put links in the description to all of these, especially this Uniseal, and because again, this is the magic that makes it work. So all total, I mean, right at $50 for this and entire build, which I think is a great price. But because I've used 3 nipples on mine, and these, and both the Uniseals and the nipples come in packs of 5, I had to buy 2 packages of each. So I've got, so for that, you know, I guess $50 in total cost for this first one, I've got enough spare parts to build a second one with, or at least spare parts on the Uniseal and the nipples to build a second one and have one left over. So if I did the math and did a, I guess the true per unit cost of one water, it would be less than that. Okay, so the first step on this build is going to be to drill the 3 holes for the nipples and the pipe to go in. And there's a lot, as many videos as there are on YouTube about these DIY pig waters, there are also as to how high up, how high down these pig nipples should go, or how far over. And you know, I read something online that said the pigs are supposed to kind of reach up, and that the nipples are supposed to be kind of above shoulder level, and that kind of makes sense to me. I saw one video where the guy had actually kind of staggered all of the nipple heights to accommodate the pigs through their various growing phases, and I actually thought that was pretty cool. I saw a lot of videos where the folks put the nipples pretty high up so that the weight, the extra weight of the water helps keep them from moving around. Now what I do is I'm going to put mine pretty low, about 4.5 inches from the bottom of the barrel. And then when I put it in the pasture or in the pig pen, I'm going to put it up on a couple mason bricks, and then I can, or cinder blocks, sorry, and I can continue to move it up higher if needed. Again, I don't know that there's a right answer or a wrong answer, but that's where I'm going to do it. So let's get these holes drilled. Okay, so here are my holes. Again, nothing magical. They're about 4.5 inches, I would say, from the bottom of the barrel. And I spaced them about 12 inches apart. I only do 3 and kind of, angle them out like this, because I like to put the barrel up next to the fence line so that I can fill it easily from the outside. All right, so for the next step, we're gonna assemble the PVC fittings and the nipples. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna glue these fittings onto the ends of the PVC. So I'm gonna take my little primer, side of these. My calves are in the pen right next to me. I guess they're wanting a piece of the action there. Probably won't know why I've been here so long and haven't given them any attention yet. Okay, so then we're gonna add a little glue to this. And I suspect there's probably, like everything else on here, a supposed to do way, and then there's my way. Now, as I've mentioned, my background is not farming. It's not even a farming related skill type job. My background is finance, accounting, and technology. So literally everything I'm learning out here, I'm learning as I go. So I could be doing this wrong, but I know that this is the way I did the other one, and it seems to hold water and works. All right, so those three are now glued up and ready to go. So then the next step is going to be to apply some Teflon tape to these fittings here, these nipples, so we get a pretty good seal. And we screw those in. And now these are ready to go into here, but I'm gonna let that glue kind of set up just a second. I mean, these are already pretty set up, so I don't think it's going anywhere, but mainly just because as I start twisting and tightening, I don't wanna get this glue all over me. Okay, it's been a few minutes, so let's finish putting this together. So I'm just gonna take, basically, screw this in. Take my wrench. I'm not gonna do super tight, but just give it a little extra twist just to make sure it's seated good. And that one's ready to go. Then this one. Now that one's ready to go. And then this one. And now that one's ready to go. So now it's time for the final assembly. So here's the final assembly for those pig water. Now I did, while I was waiting on the glue to dry a little bit, I did go rinse this thing out again. A couple of these little blue discs from when I drilled the hole had fallen into the inside. And I don't think it really would have mattered. There would have been no way to, I think, for it to clog up or cause any problem. I wanted to get them out of there anyway, so I did that. And I also used my knife just to, or a few little burrs on this to smooth that out. So now the next step is you take these little Uniseal, and again, it's pretty easy. You put it in the hole, in each of the holes to serve them here. And then this last step, you basically just take your nipple assembly and you put it in hole. Now this was the first time I built this. I did have a little bit of trouble forcing those in. I mean, it's a pretty tight fit. So I thought I'd get a bucket of water, dip them in the water and see if the water kind of act like a lubricant to make that a little bit easier. Yeah, maybe a little bit. I don't know. So that just pushes all the way in. And then take your next one. Push that one all the way in. And then the last one. That's it. And see, the way these Unicel work, if you look at their website, you push that in, it kind of balloons and expands the back side of this and creates that seal. But what I like about it on that, you know, the bulkhead method, the ones that we've all seen a bunch of videos about, it's very rigid. So my thought is just, you know, again, new to pigs, but did a bunch of research, and they seem to be that they can be a pretty destructive animal. So you see if the thought of them breaking this off and leaking water all over the place, having to start again. But what I like about this is, you know, that, so that now sticks about 7 inches in, and you know, they can pull and bend on this. See, and that's got a lot of flexibility in it. And so I think it's gonna be a little bit more resistant to breaking off, because again, they can bend and pull on that. And like I said, those just stick in there and the water is going to flow. And I guess in the unlikely event one of them did break it off, this would be pretty easy to repair. So that's it. I hope y'all like this video. With this DIY pig water, you know, I'm gonna go install it in the field and put it to work. Now I do prop this up on a couple of center blocks, like I mentioned, and I will take two T-posts and put on each side to kind of support it. I don't know that if it's needed, and then because in addition to the two T-posts, I'll run a ratchet strap around just to hold it. And again, don't know if that's really needed, but I'm gonna do it anyway. And again, I will, you know, these will stay pretty much where it's at for several weeks. I probably will rotate this along with the pigs and the food within their individual paddocks to try to keep the you know, the disperse the damage, so that one area doesn't get more worn than the other. But if you have any questions or comments on this, feel free to put it down in the comment section. I'd love to hear from y'all. I will link all of these parts in the description, and so that you can find it. Again, hope you enjoyed this video, and look forward to seeing you pretty soon.